Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand I/O operations on a basic computer. So the concept of I/O configuration and the concepts related to I/O instructions has already been covered in our previous videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here, because this video is a continuation video for those videos. So without understanding those concepts, you may not be able to understand what we are going to discuss in this class. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And now, coming to this class, we will try to understand how the I/O operations, how the input operations and how the output operations will get executed on our basic computer. So this is our basic computer block diagram. So on this computer, whenever the input is provided to the computer, whenever we press a key on the input device, it is a keyboard. So how the content will get stored onto the memory? So every content has to be stored onto the memory. So whenever the inputs are provided, so those inputs are to be stored onto the memory, and whenever we require those values, we are going to fetch those values from the memory. So this is how the programs will work, right? So in order to make that happen, how that input operation will get happen, that we will try to understand. So whenever an input device, input device is getting activated, in the sense whenever the values are pressed on the input devices, so it will get transferred onto the adder and logic unit. From here, it will get transferred onto the accumulator. So the input value will get stored onto the accumulator, and now this is what we call it as input operation. So from here, what we have to do is, the value that is stored in the accumulator has to be stored onto the memory. Because whenever a program asks for the input that is provided by the user, so that value has to be fetched and used within the program. It may be used for output operation, or it may be used for computing something that is related to the program. For example, if the input on this keyboard, so on this input device, for example, if one is pressed, so this one has to be transferred onto the ALU in the sense adder and logic unit, and that one will get transferred onto the accumulator. Now what happens is, this value that is provided by the input device has to be stored onto the memory. So in order to make that happen, we have to execute memory reference instruction called store accumulator. What it will do is, the content of the accumulator will get transferred onto the memory. So the discussion about memory reference instructions has already been made. So from here, the content of the accumulator will get accessed, and it will get transferred onto the bus, and through the bus it will get transferred into the memory unit, and it will get stored at some location on this memory. For example, if it is stored, one is stored here in some location. Now, this is how the input operations will get executed on our basic computer. Now, I would like to access. So the program would like to access this value one. This value one has to be accessed, and it has to be printed onto the, it has to be stored onto this output device, and from here it will get printed on the printer. So how this is going to happen? So in order to make that happen, what we have to do is, the content on this memory unit has to be transferred onto the bus, and from here it will get transferred onto the data register, and this one will get stored on this data register. And after that, so after that, what happens? So this is what we call it as output operation. So from the data register, so how this operation will get performed? It is load AC, load accumulator. So loading the accumulator. So after transferring the content onto the data register, we have to load the accumulator. So how the load accumulator is performed is, the data value that is stored in the accumulator can be passed. See here, the data register is connected to the adder logic unit, adder and logic unit. Through this, the content will get stored onto this accumulator. So this one will get stored on this accumulator through the data register. So, and from the accumulator we have to, so this operation is what we call it as load accumulator. So the values in the memory register will get transferred onto the data register, and from the data register the value of the accumulator will get filled with this value. So now from here we have to do the output operation, in the sense the value one has to be transferred. The value that is stored in the accumulator has to be transferred onto the output register. So how that can be done? So the value that is stored on the accumulator will be transferred onto the common bus, and from here it will go into the output register. So this is how the input and output operations are performed on the computer. How these operations are performed? So this is, we have seen the overview. So this is how the operations will get performed. That we have understood, but how these operations will get performed, that is very important to understand. So there are two different ways to make these functions happen, make these operations happen. One of the way is programmed IO. One of the way is programmed IO operation, and the next one is input interrupt. Interrupt-driven IO. These are the two different kinds of operations. These are the two different ways in which the input and output operations can be performed. And the very important point that we have to understand is, on our basic computer, whatever the operation may be, it may be an input operation or the output operation, it is going to take the help of the CPU. CPU in the sense, this ALU. So with this ALU, we are going to do. So whenever we want to do an input operation, whenever we want to do an output operation, so whenever the IO operations are performed, the very important point that we have to understand is, it happens through the use of this arithmetic logic unit or the CPU. Okay, so this is very important point to understand. And how those operations, input output operations, are performed is, there are two ways. One is programmed IO. In our next video we are going to cover how the programmed IO will help us, the execution of how the input output operations are performed by using the programmed IO. And in our next, after that, we will try to understand the demerits of programmed IO, and from there we will try to understand how the interrupt driven IO will get implemented. So this is how the operations, IO operations, will work on a computer. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol, and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.